Hi everyone, it's Stephanie and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be all about my MiraDry treatment and experience and all of that. So if you're not familiar with what MiraDry is, MiraDry is a FDA approved procedure that's a non-invasive treatment to help reduce sweat glands and odor glands using heat energy. And what this is basically used for is people who have excessive underarm sweating. Something I wanted to talk about on my channel for probably a long time now. I just kind of like was a little bit embarrassed and kind of nervous to share it, which I don't know why, because it's just something that I've dealt with like for a very, very long time. Have had excessive underarm sweat since I can remember. I would say like probably starting around 13 when I was going through puberty. I just had a lot of excess underarm sweating. It was very embarrassing for me. Even to this day, it's still extremely embarrassing that I would be sweating so bad in situations that you don't sweat in. So you guys know I live in Chicago. We have cold, brutal, brutal winters. It will be negative 10 outside and I will be sweating under my arms. Like even if I'm standing outside in the cold, sweating. Sweating to the point that it's ruining my clothes. Not only on top of the sweat, I would have like an odor as well, like just underarm odor. And I would use deodorant. I would, you know, constantly clean under my arms, use deodorant, and literally just nothing was helping it. And it just got to the point where I am like fed up with it. And I was like, I need a solution. It has played such a huge part on like my mental health. Like I am very embarrassed. I'm very self-conscious of it. It's just something that was affecting my day-to-day life. So I knew I needed to find some sort of solution to get rid of this. I've been to dermatologists. I've tried, you know, my dermatologist didn't even want to give me prescription deodorant because he thought it was going to cause a rash, or just the harsh chemicals inside of it are just really not that good for you to be putting on your skin. As well as I've tried like these wipes that are like so expensive, and I mean expensive, like I'm talking like $600 for a box of wipes that might last you like a week. There's also the option to do Botox. You would get 10 units of Botox in each underarm, which would probably put you at about $2,000 every 3 to 6 months, depending on how your body takes to Botox and all that stuff. So I knew that that was not going to be an option for me because it wasn't a permanent solution, right? These were all temporary solutions to the problem of sweating. For the years, I've been like waiting for something to try to find something that I can do to help control the sweating under my arms. I was just felt like I was at this point, there's no hope. I'm just gonna have to deal with the fact that I have sweating, this massive sweating problem under my arm. This was just something that needed to be solved because I couldn't take the excessive sweating under my arms anymore. I couldn't wear colored clothes. I could literally only wear black. I couldn't wear white, like literally nothing, because I would ruin the clothes like no other. Like I would have pit stains, I would have odor, I would just be sweating so bad. So it was just really hard for me to wear anything that was a color because I would ruin it. So then I started seeing about this MiraDry procedure treatment through social media. I saw a lot of people from Bachelor Nation doing it. I saw a lot of people from Real Housewives of New Jersey. I think like Teresa's daughter Gia got it. I saw Dolores Catania from Real Housewives of New Jersey get it. Joe Gorga. I saw like a ton of people getting this done on Instagram. And I was like, what is this MiraDry like? So when I found MiraDry, I went ahead and looked it up online and I found a doctor that was in my area that actually did MiraDry. So I will leave the MiraDry link down below where you guys can check out to see if there's a provider near you. This video is not sponsored whatsoever by MiraDry. This is all on my own experience. I paid for all this on my own. I'm just very, very grateful and thankful for MiraDry that something like this exists because it really, really did help me. And it's only been like 3 weeks since I've gotten my procedure. So I love it. And I just wanted to share my experience because there's like a very few videos out there on it. So I figured that I would share with mine. I was battling with excessive sweating for so long. I thought there was no other solution. I really like look to YouTube a lot of the time to see if anyone else was experiencing it, because I literally honestly for the longest time thought that there was something like wrong with me because I was sweating so bad, and like there's nobody else in my family that has this problem that I know of. So when I found MiraDry, it was like the gates of heaven were opening because I was like, finally, there's something for me that I can do and try. So MiraDry is a little bit on the pricier side, but it is worth the investment because this is a permanent solution to excessive sweating. So the one treatment costs about $1,900. If you get, depending on where you go, some places offer some type of like deal. So the place that I did go to, they did offer a deal that was like, if you get two treatments, you kind of save a little bit of money. So it would be like $2,700 instead of paying $1,900 twice. You get a little bit of a break. And like I said, I will leave all that information down below, what location I went to as well, in case you are interested in getting it and you live in the Chicagoland area. So I went ahead, made my appointment for, the MiraDry. You do get a free consultation at the place that I went to. I've went to one other place to get a consultation and I did not like it. So I went to this other place. I got a consultation. It was a free consultation. They kind of look over and see if you're a good candidate. They just kind of ask you a few questions, if you excessively sweat, blah, blah, blah. They also do like this template to make, to measure out your underarm area to see how much, they'll actually have to numb when you do your actual treatment. So that consultation went really well. I then went ahead and booked my appointment. So my appointment was made for Thursday, March 25th. That's when I got my first treatment. And it is now Saturday, April 10th. So I'm filming this a few weeks. I did vlog my experience, so I will be showing you guys day to day the progress, what my underarms look like. You guys will be seeing up close and personal of my underarm area. So it's not that pretty, but it's an armpit. I mean, I don't think they're pretty anyways, but you get what I'm saying. So I will share with you guys a little bit how each day went. What you do is when you first go back in, you go back into the room, the doctor will come in and then they will do a temporary tattoo on your underarms to kind of have that grid area so that they know where to work on your underarms and where to kind of put that plated heat energy onto your underarm. So they go ahead and do the temporary tattoo. After they do that, a nurse will come in and she will numb your underarms. They do fill you up with some like fluid numbing underneath your arms. That does take probably the longest. I think that would take maybe even longer than the treatment because it really takes a lot to numb your underarm area, especially when you have such a long, bigger area to cover. So they go ahead and numb you and then they start doing the machine. So they turn on this like little handheld like gun energy machine and they just go all over your underarm. I will try to insert some clips of like what it looks like, or pictures or something like that so that you guys know what I'm talking about. So they put that over your arms and under your arms and then they go over that about 30 times on each side and that's it. And then 1, 2, 3, they give you ice packs and then ice packs to go home with. The location that I did go to, they did provide me with an anti-inflammatory prescription for 3 days. It's kind of up to each location. I'm not sure if everywhere does that, but that's what they did at the place that I went to. Helped with the swelling because you will be very swollen underneath your underarms because again, they're filling it up with liquid and fluid and you were, you know, heat energy was applied there. So basically the heat energy is like sucking up your skin to this machine and then it's like killing the sweat gland. The first treatment is going to reduce about 50% of your sweat glands and then the second treatment will reduce up to 80% of your sweat glands will be killed. And on top of the sweat glands being killed, you also are going to eliminate the odor glands and you are also going to kind of give yourself a little bit laser hair removal. So it's kind of like a bonus, a 3-in-1. So again, this is a permanent solution to sweat and it is pricey, but it's definitely worth it. The experience was very good for me. I'm gonna go ahead now and insert some of my clips from those few days that I did vlog, my experience, my pain, showing you guys underneath my arms and all that stuff. And then I will come back and give you guys my final thoughts on the MiraDry procedure. Good morning, everybody. So today is Thursday, March 25th. I am going to be leaving here in about 30 minutes to head out to my MiraDry procedure today. I am so excited and nervous. It's like a whole bunch of emotions. I've never really had any type of like procedure or anything like that ever. So I'm a little bit nervous, but I know that the place I'm going to, I trust everyone there and I'm very, very excited to get this MiraDry procedure. So you guys would have seen already the beginning part of this video, I kind of explained exactly what MiraDry is and everything about it and a little bit of my background on why I chose to get MiraDry.
in the first place. So yeah, we are gonna go today. I'm going to take you throughout today and probably the next few days to just kind of show you the overall process, the healing process, and just kind of keep you guys updated throughout this little procedure. I also think I'm gonna do like a follow-up after like a month just to check in, see how it's going. So yeah, I'm really excited. Like I said, I am a little bit nervous just because, I mean, any procedure you get nervous. So I am already this morning really, really sweating. And it's gonna be up close and personal today. You guys are gonna be seeing a great look at my armpits for most of the day. So anyways, but I got this sports bra from Walmart, and then I'm gonna wear a tank top because you have to wear a tank style tee for the procedure because obviously it's under your arms. So that's that. I'm going to see if I can get some footage inside there. If not, there's tons and tons of videos online showing the actual procedure, so you can just look that up. But if I can, I will. If I can't, I can't. Because every facility is different and I haven't said anything that I had a YouTube channel or anything like that. So I don't want to like pop that in on them in case they don't want to be on camera. So, but anyways, I'm going to head downstairs now and get ready to head out because where I'm going is about 45 minutes away from where I am. So I will leave the information as to where I got my Miradry at. If you're in the Chicagoland area, I will link it down below, the exact place that I went to. So let's go ahead and get this journey started. I just got back home. Me and my mom are going to have lunch. The whole process was very simple, very easy. Didn't really feel anything. Obviously you're getting numb, so you're gonna feel like the little pricks from like the needles, and then you may have areas where you will feel the actual Miradry procedure. You can feel like it's kind of like a heat sensation, like almost like a burning sensation that you might feel, because that area just needs to be numbed a little bit better. So I'll show you guys my underarms. This is not pretty, but you can see that they're a little bit swollen. You can kind of see some markings on there because obviously they do like a temporary tattoo, and then they go ahead and mark you to see like what areas they need to do the treatment. So this is what it looks like. I probably will have some bruising, she said, as possible. Some people don't bruise, some people do. I'll show you this armpit. This is up close and personal. So this is what this one looks like. So it is a little bit swollen. This one looks like it's a little bit more swollen than this one. So I am just gonna take it easy for the day. They gave me ice packs. I will check in with you guys a little bit later today to see like the updates, anything. So right now I can't really feel anything because I'm still numb. So I will check in after a few hours or so and see how I'm doing. Alrighty guys, so it is right now currently, let's see, what time is it? It is 4:52. I got my procedure done this morning at 9 a.m. So it's currently 4:52. It's about to be 5 o'clock. I am now starting to feel the, like, pain. I say pain very loosely. I also changed into a tank top because I feel better with having a tank top on. I don't really like when there's like clothing touching underneath, and it's not good to wear tight clothing, so it's good to wear like loose clothing as well. I'll probably end up changing again when I go to bed and put on like a baggy t-shirt, but right now I'm about to ice my underarms. So I just put them under here and then ice them, but I'll show you guys an update of what they look like right now. So it's probably kind of gross, but you guys can see they are pretty swollen. I know this looks really gross, but you guys can see it's pretty swollen here. And then I'll show you guys this one as well. Pretty swollen. It looks more swollen than earlier. I wouldn't necessarily say it's a pain. I would say it's more of like a burning sensation, but I do find relief with the ice pack. So that's one thing that is like my saving grace is ice pack. I did take 2 ibuprofens. They did give me prescription prednisone, but that's only if you have really severe pain. So I don't think I'm going to be using that in the near future at all, honestly. But if I do get more pain tonight, I might take prednisone just so that I can sleep a little bit better and not have to worry about the pain. So just checking with you guys, wanted to give you an update, see how I was doing. We've just been relaxing, not doing much, catching up on YouTube videos and all that. So I am now gonna go ahead, ice my underarms for about 20 to 30 minutes, and then I'm going to check in probably a little bit later. So that's like my midday update for you guys, but yeah, so far the experience has been pretty well, pretty easy, and just relaxing. So I'll see you guys in the next clip. Hello guys, so it is the next day. It is Friday, March 26th. I do have a shirt on. I have a tube top on actually, because I just feel like it's better with my arms. So right now I'm currently icing underneath. They just provided me these ice packs. So I wanted to give you guys an update of just everything last night and then how I'm healing and all that. So last night I did end up taking I did take some ibuprofen. I wouldn't necessarily categorize this as any sort of pain. I would say more so it's like a sunburn feeling. So if you've ever had really, really bad sunburn, that's kind of what it feels like. It's very like burning sensation, very tender skin. So I had that last night. The only thing that seems to relieve that is definitely the ice packs. They're like my savior through this all. On a scale of 1 to 10 pain, I'd say it's about a 3. I don't really think it's even painful. And I have low pain tolerance, so keep that in mind. Also last night was difficult to sleep because I couldn't get comfortable. So I kept tossing and turning, laying on my back, trying to lay on my side. I couldn't really lay on my side. So it was kind of just all over the place with that. And so yeah, I just kind of toss and turn the whole night. So this morning I'm feeling much better. That burning sensation has kind of gone away, but it is very tender underneath the arms. It's very swollen still. So I will show you guys, this is this arm. So if you guys can see, it is pretty swollen still. You can see it's a little bit red, but I just had the ice packs on. I'll show you guys this side. Now, this side, if you guys can see, like it's way puffier here. I would also say that it feels like you have two heavy water balloons laying on underneath your arms. Like that's kind of what it feels like. It's hard to put your arms all the way down. It's best to have them kind of like out. I find that's what's been helping me. But other than that, feels pretty good today. I know that tomorrow it's gonna be feeling even better, and I know that by Sunday it would be feeling even more better. So yeah, this has been a really good process so far. Also, update, no sweat whatsoever underneath my arms. It's going to be immediate results like I discussed earlier in the vlog. But yeah, so I'm just going to relax for the rest of the day, keep hydrated. I'm watching some Netflix, catching up on YouTube videos, and then also just like looking at outfits for my birthday, because I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to be able to wear like a colored dress and not have to stress about wearing color and worrying about sweating. So I'm gonna go ahead and relax for the rest of the day.
So that is basically the few days that I vlogged. I think I vlogged about 3 days, 4 days or so. Overall experience was really, really pleasant. I didn't have any issues or anything like that. It was super quick and just a quick recovery too. There wasn't like literally no downtime. I just decided to be a person to take 2 days off of work just because I didn't want to be uncomfortable, because I would say the most thing about this procedure is you are a little bit uncomfortable under the arms. And I would say the most uncomfortable day would be the first day that you get it. And then each day after that gets easier and easier. What I would recommend is continuously icing your underarms, because I found that that helped and provided so much relief for me. Because it wasn't like a pain, but it was like a little bit of a burning sensation. But other than that, super, super easy. You do have to put on some antibacterial polysporin underneath your arms and just make sure that you're cleaning your underarms with antibacterial soap every day after it. Don't shave for about 2 weeks after, because you are very tender. I would say I shaved my underarms about a week and a half after it, because I just felt like I was fine too, and I was totally fine to do a week and a half. If you need longer, then do so. I do use deodorant still, because I do have a little bit of odor left, but it's kind of like a natural odor, so I would say that the deodorant is definitely doing its job. I've been using spray deodorant instead, and I'm actually really liking it. And probably you guys want to know most about the sweating. So it has been, I think it's been 2 weeks since I've gotten, let's see, one, two, yeah. It's been 2 weeks this past Thursday since I've gotten the procedure. My sweating has reduced probably about 50%. So I'm still sweating, but it's probably a normal level of sweat. It's not anything like I was sweating before. Before, I would literally feel the sweat dripping down the side of my arms. Like, it was disgusting. I would feel the sweat dripping down my stomach. Like, not good. So I do not sweat like that anymore. I'm still sweating, but it's nothing compared to what I was sweating like before. So the treatment definitely does work. I definitely will most likely be getting the second treatment. And with the second treatment, you do have to wait between, I think it's within 3 months of your first one. So you have to wait 3 months and then you can get the second one. So I probably won't get another one until around August. They just want you to make sure that you've taken the time to see if really evaluate if you need it or not. So I'm definitely gonna use that 3 months to see if I really do need it. I definitely think I'm going to, but I'm already so much happier and so much like just stress relieved. The fact that I don't have to worry about me constantly sweating under my arms all the time. Like, it's such a relief. I can't even explain to you guys how much of a relief this is, how much I feel so much happier that I don't have to worry about constantly sweating under my arms, constantly being embarrassed. It's been something I've been so embarrassed of for a very, very long time. And I'm sharing with you guys because it was an experience and something that I had to deal with for a very long time because I thought there was no answers. So when I found MiraDry, I was like, I just have to share this with you guys and share my experience. And yeah, so overall, I really do recommend getting MiraDry if you are an excessive sweater underneath your arms. It really does help. It's non-invasive. It's literally no downtime. Recovery is literally like nothing. So yeah, those are my overall thoughts on the MiraDry procedure. If you guys have any other questions about the procedure, the treatment, all that stuff, I will leave the comment section open for you guys to go ahead and leave me some comments. I will try to answer each one as best as I can if you guys have any. Also, I will link all of the MiraDry stuff as well as the website to MiraDry and the location that I went and got my MiraDry procedure at. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked this video, give this video a thumbs up. If you guys want me to do like another check-in for MiraDry, let me know. And like I said, leave me any comments or questions down below and I will answer them the best that I can. And I will see all of your beautiful faces in my next video. And remember to never stop dreaming. Bye, guys.